ब्रह्मादय सुरगना मुनक मुनयूथ सिद्ध्या सत्तान गतयु वचसांग प्रवाहय नारादितंग पुरगन रधुना पिप्रो किंतोष्ट मरहति समे हरि रुग्र जाते। टुडे आई शैल रिसाइड बिफोर यू द प्रेयर्स ऑफर्ड बाय प्रह्लाद महाराज टू निशिमहादेव। This Prahlad Maharaj was tortured by his father on account of his becoming a Krishna conscious boy. The only fault was that don't make it open. Prahlad Maharaj was a boy, 5 years old, youngest son of his father, very affectionate son. But one day the father took the little boy on his lap and asked the boy, "My dear child, what you have learned the best from your teachers, will you kindly explain?" Prahlad Maharaj answered, "Tat sadhu manne suravajya dihinam sada samud vigna dhyam asad grahat hityatma ghatam griha anda kupam Banangato jad harimasrayita." The father asked, "The best thing the boy learned from his teachers," and the boy, 5 years old boy, replied, "My dear, best of the demons, he never addressed his father, my dear father," because his father was atheist number one, godless, and he was a great devotee of God. So when the father inquired, he straightly replied, he knew that his father was very powerful demon, but he was not afraid. Although he was 5 years old boy, he plainly replied, "My dear, the best of the demons, Asuravarja. Asura means demons, and Varja means the best, first class demon. So I think that sadhu means honest, or very good, very nice. That is very nice. What is that? Dehinam, for the entities who have accepted this material body." He is speaking universally, not for himself or for his father, but he was speaking generally for everybody. Everybody. Anyone. Dehinam. Dehi means this body. We are different from this body. We have several times discussed this point. So, in Sanskrit word, there are two implication in the understanding of our existence. One is deha. Deha means this body. And dehi means the proprietor of the body. I am the proprietor of my body. You are the proprietor of your body. So, Prahlad Maharaj says, for all the proprietors of the body, that means for everyone who has accepted this material body, all living entities. That is the best thing. What is that? Sada samudvigna dhiyam. And anyone who has accepted this material body, his symptom is that he is full of anxieties. This is the disease. To get this body, material body, means to remain always full of anxieties. Either you become the first class, I mean the executive head, President Johnson, or an ordinary man in the Bowery Street. Everyone is full of anxiety. Not only human society, but also bird society, beast society, everyone. Anyone who has got this material body is full of anxiety. But we want to get free from anxiety. That is our aspiration. So Prahlad Maharaj suggests the remedy, how to become free from anxieties. He says, Hitya atmaghatam grihayanda kupam. Atmaghatam, atma means the soul, and ghatam means killing. Hitmatma ghatam grihayanda kupam. Andhakup means blind well. Blind well, I do not know whether you have got experience. In India, there are several old wells on the paddy fields and they are covered with grass. Nobody can understand that there is a well underneath this grass. And if by mistake one comes there, he falls down, say 100 feet down, and it is covered with grass. Even if he cries, please save me, who is going to save him? Sometimes cow and animals and man fall down in that way. If he's fortunate enough, somebody comes and rescues. Otherwise, generally, there is no rescue. Who is going to know that there is a man or there is an animal? So, hitmatma ghatam grihanda kupam. This material world is just like that blind well. If somebody falls down in it, it is very difficult to get out of it. Therefore, it is atma ghatam. Atma ghatam means killing the soul. How we are killing the soul? We forget that I am spirit soul. Therefore, almost every one of us is forgetful that I am spirit soul. I am identifying with this body. And Prahlad Maharaj says, because we have identified with this body, therefore we are always anxious, full of anxieties. And that is the fact. Therefore the whole process of knowledge is, some of my students, she is present here, she asked, what is knowledge? The knowledge is that I am not this body. This is knowledge. Knowledge does not mean that how you can manufacture nuclear weapon. That is not knowledge. That is illusion. Real knowledge is to know the simple fact that I am not this body. That's all. But that knowledge is very rare. And to acquire that knowledge, there are so many systems. That system is called self-realization. There is yoga system, there is jnana system, jnana yoga, dhyana yoga, karma yoga. There are so many yoga systems simply to come to the platform of this knowledge that I am not this body. And as soon as one comes to this platform, that I am not this body, then what happens to him? Brahma-bhuta, self-realized. And what is that self-realization? What is the symptom? How I can understand that one is self-realized? Prasanna-atma is jolly. So long we do not come to that platform of knowledge, we are full of anxieties. And as soon as we come to the platform of knowledge that I am not this body, the immediate symptom is joyfulness, prasanna-atma. How that prasanna-atma is manifested, everything is there. Na sochati, na kankhati. Sochati means lamentation. And kankhati means hankering. These two things will disappear. Sochati, if we lose something, then we lament. Oh, I have lost so much money, I have lost my son, I have lost my service and so many things. And kankhati, kankhati means I haven't got this, I want this, I haven't got this. These two kinds of diseases makes us always full of anxieties. Why you are anxious? For these two things, sochati and kankhati. Lamentation for the loss and hankering after which we do not possess. Prahlad Maharaj says that if somebody wants to get free from this anxiety, and this anxiety is due to asat-grahat means for accepting this temporary body. Asat means temporary, that will not exist. So Prahlad Maharaj suggests the remedy that if anyone wants to get free from anxieties, because this anxiety is sure and certain for everyone who has got this material body. But if he wants to get free from it, then hityatmaghatam grihandakupam, the so-called atmosphere of material happiness, he should give up and vanangato harimasrayata, and go to the forest and accept the lotus feet of Hari, or the Supreme Personality of God. The same instruction is everywhere. In the Bhagavad Gita also the same instruction is there. Sarva-dharmān parityajyamāmekaṁ saraṇam. The one word is that unless and until we take shelter of the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, there is no, possibility of our getting free from the anxiety of material existence. So when Prahlad Maharaj explained this verse to his father, atheistic father, he was so angry that he threw him from his lap. You nonsense, what you are speaking? Yes. Actually, this is the position. Materialistic persons are so much engrossed in their own thought that if somebody goes there and speaks of Krishna consciousness as the solution for all problems, he immediately throws it out. Just like Prahlad Maharaj's father did it. So from that day there was misunderstanding between the father and the son. Ultimately, the father tortured him in so many ways, and at last, the Supreme Personality of Godhead appeared in Nrisimhadeva form. Nrisimhadeva means he appeared just like a lion and half man. Very big form. The demon was also very stout and strong. So he wanted to be immortal. His purpose was to become immortal and enjoy this material world perpetually, but that was not fulfilled. So when that demon Hiranyakashipu was killed, the Lord was very much in angry mood, and all the demigods present there, they could not pacify the Lord. He was groaning in anger. So they selected Prahlad Maharaj, that my dear boy, it is for you. The Lord has appeared. So you kindly try to pacify the Lord. You can do it. So Prahlad Maharaj is praying to pacify the Lord. The first verse is that Brahmadaya Suragana Munayotha Siddhya Sattvaikatana Gatayo Vachasang Pravahai Naradhitang Puruganai Yadunapi Pipru King Tostum Marahati Same Hari Rugrajati. He is humbly presenting himself. This is the qualification of pure devotee. Although Prahlad Maharaj stands there, the first-class devotee, because all other demigods, they are also devotees, they could not pacify the Lord, and they pushed Prahlad Maharaj, my dear boy, you do it. So, in that meeting, he was the first-class devotee, but he presents himself that I am Ugrajati, I am born of demoniac father. So when Brahmadaya, demigods like Brahma, Suragana and other demigods, Munayo, great sages, and Siddha means those who have got many material perfection. There is a planet which is called Siddha Loka. In Siddha Loka, the inhabitants of Siddha Loka, they can fly in the air without any machine. Just like in this planet, we can fly in the space with the help of some machine. But in the Siddha Loka, they can fly in this body. They have got 8 kinds of siddhas, perfection, material perfection. So out of that, this perfection is called Laghima. They can become so light that they can fly in the air. They are called siddhas. So siddhas were also present. So Prahlad Maharaj says that here in this meeting, the demigods are there, headed by Lord Brahma, and great sages are there, and the siddhas are there, and they try to pacify the Lord by prayers with very fine language, sattvika, very selected words, just like anyone offers prayer to the Lord. They are all selected words. Therefore, Lord's name is, another name is Uttama Sloka. Uttama. Uttama Sloka means choicest words. One who is worshipped by the choicest words. So they presented the choicest words, very learned scholars, grammatical, metaphorical, everything very nice. Sattvaikatana Gatayo Bhatasang Prabhahai, and they presented their prayers just like a flow of the water. They are very learned, so there was no impediment. They could say fluently, Prabhahai. Naradhitam Puruganai Radhinapi Pipru. Prahlad Maharaj says that these demigods and sages, they could not satisfy. Still now, King Toshtum Arhati Same Harirugrajate, how it is possible that the Lord will be satisfied by my prayers? This is the humbleness. A devotee should always consider himself that he has no value. How I can satisfy Krishna, the Supreme Lord? I have no possession. That is the devotee's position. A devotee should never think that I am well equipped. I have got very nice education. I have got great riches. I am wealthy, I am beautiful, I am wise. Therefore, as soon as I pray, Krishna, please come here, he will come and dance. No. That is not the attitude of devotee. Devotee always thinks very humble, meek. This is the presentation of Prahlad Maharaj, that I am born of a father because they belong to the atheistic family, demonic family, Ugrajati. Ugrajati means they are not very sober. Always passionate, Ugrajati, always passionate. Passionate means always hankering after sense gratification. So, Prahlad Maharaj says that, I am born of a father so greatly passionate, how I can satisfy the Lord where great personalities and sages and demigods have failed. He is presenting himself so humbly. But he is intelligent. Without becoming intelligent, nobody can worship God. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is said, Krishna je bhaje sevara chatur. Chatur means very intelligent. Unless one is first-class intelligent, he cannot worship God. It is not possible. Foolish person cannot worship God. It is said in the Bhagavad Gita, Navang duskitanam mudha prapadanti naradhama mayaya aparita jnana asuri bhavamasrita. Krishna says, the Lord says, that those who are miscreants, always trying to do harm to the society, to the country, to the people, to the other animals, other living creatures, they are called duskritina, miscreants. Miscreants, namang duskritinam mudha, and fools. So, miscreants, fools, and naradhama. Naradhama means the lowest of the mankind. Naradhama. And maya aparita jnana, and one whose knowledge is taken away by the illusory energy. Who are they? So-called educated. The so-called educated persons, they are very much proud of their university degree. But if you ask some of them, what you are, where from you have come to this world, and where you are going next? They will say, what is this nonsense? I do not know where from I have come, where I am going. I am no concern with that. I am concerned with the present life, that's all. But actually, we are not this present life. It is only a spot in our